file on your computer, and it says photos on it. So you open up that file, and you see a bunch of photos, right? You click on one, now you see the photo. So what's happening is you're looking at the photo, right? Now, if you hit the X, the photo goes away back into the file, right? Make sense? Same way your brain works. You have subconscious and conscious mind. So the photo is on the conscious part of the computer because you're looking at it. When you close it, now it's in the subconscious. It's still there, it can be accessed. It's like your mind, right? You have millions of names in your mind, but when I get you to focus on one, now it's in your conscious part. That gives me 20 seconds to grab it. So he could have thought of any name, he's focusing on this name, and now it's he brought it from here to here. Okay, so how is that going to help you in your everyday life or in your work environment? It's very simple. Do not second guess your intuition, right? And get into a mindset of trying to pick up whatever it is you want to know. So if you want to know something, try and pick it up. Now, I know that sounds far-fetched, but how many times have you been with a girlfriend or a boyfriend and you guys are in the car and you're thinking of something and then you mention it and she says, you know what, I was just thinking that same thing. Okay? Have you experienced that?
Always.
This happens. I'm just bringing it to another level. Right? It's like a, let me explain to you what I'm, how I fit into this. We all can drive a car, but then Jeff Gordon can really drive a car. That's why he's making millions in NASCAR. But we all can do it. We all have the ability to do what I'm doing here. It's about how we use it, right? People are afraid to use it or think they can't do it. So if you think you can't do something, you're not going to be able to do it. Okay? I've never thought that I was anything special. Okay, I'm just using more of my brain than most people. But you all can use this. So, with objects too. So for instance, let's try this. Let's look at, actually, you know what? Before I go into this, I'm gonna do this. His coins, this is their coins. Now, this is a nickel. It's strong, it's small, they're built to last a very long time. I wanna ask you a question. If I told you to take that nickel and bend it, would that even thought even cross your mind?
Like an everyday fast, you know?
No, just off the cuff. Hey, bend this nickel. Just sit down and think about it and see if you can just bend it with strength or focus.
No, I would not think about it.
You wouldn't think about it because it's so far out of the realm of things. It's not even something that you would even think about doing. That's the kind of thinking that you cannot have, right? You can't have this is impossible thinking, right? You ever see the guy, the karate guy that chops the bricks? He's not using strength. He's using focus and energy. Okay? And it comes from here. Again, somebody's gonna laugh at you if you say, hey, you think you could bend that. In fact, it never even crosses somebody's mind. How many people do you see play with paper clips and bend them? You see my point? Put your initials on that.
Either side or?
Whatever you want. Now, show it to everybody. Oh, you gotta do, did you do both initials?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, A-E, okay, I didn't see that. Why did I have them do this?
So we can
make sure that it's his coin.
Stand up for us. And come on, stop. Hold your hand out. Just like, yeah, just like that. What else?
You gotta bend it.
So I don't switch it.
Yeah, no, yeah, that's what I said.
Watch the coin. I wanna bend it a little bit more. Let's take it to another step.
Can you bend it back?
I'll get to that. Back to that one.
But we will do it. I should have done it after I did that. I gotta take a little rest before I get into that.
But before we get into this.
What did you do? Any scratch?
No, I didn't.
Energy.
I'm gonna do that in a minute. But pass that around to show everybody. And I want everybody to look at that coin. And let's see if we can check that one out. Put your initials on there for me. And I'm going to put the energy somewhere else. You're going to see it in a minute. Would you come up? And would you grab a penny too? Can you put both your initials on the? Okay. Now wait a minute, what coin is that?
This is my hand.
That's your coin.
The coin, yeah. Where's the phone?
I'm gonna use. Where is it?
I think it was from my country. That's what I thought.
Is this from your country?
It's from my country.
All right, we're going to do this. Do me a favor, right or left-handed? All right, would you stand over here? And where does it say that on there?
It says TS. What are you talking about?
No, the country.
So Nicaragua, Cordoba is the name of the currency.
Cool. Now, what I want you to do is hold out your hand, but just relax it for me, like this. Just relax it. And can you stand right here? Perfect. And just relax. Okay, perfect. And we're gonna try this. With the coin. Hold your hand extended, and just relax. Close your hand, not too tight. Extend your arm. Now, you're gonna feel something happen, but not yet. You ready? You feel anything. What I want you to do now is move your hands around the coin. You feel it changing in any way? Not yet? How about now?
Is it still flat? All right, turn your hand over. Open it up. Watch it bend. See it? You feel that? This is you. Not me. Go ahead, put your finger on it. This finger. You're gonna feel it heat a little bit. Now push down, and you'll see it bend. A little bit more. You see that? You feel that? You feel that happening?
Can you
put it on? No. Show everybody that it's bent. So, ripping a penny in half is one thing, ripping it three times is another. Bending coins, all this stuff can be made possible by never telling yourself you cannot do it. Once you tell yourself that, and I'm not expecting you guys to take this and be able to do it now, but what I do want you to do, just remember that it can be done, okay? That anything can be done. Now, you have his form going, right? Perfect. So, yeah, just pass those around, whoever they belong to, that's
keeping. Give them all back to the
bench. Huh?
Give them all back to the bench.
Yeah, I always, in particular, about bending coins that are foreign, because you never know if they have, you know, meaning or something. So, I need two women to help me out. You in the back, what's your name?
Rebecca.
Rebecca. Can you, you help me out?
Sure.
Okay, what I want you to do is come up. Folks, give her a round of applause. Okay. Stand right here. Now, right or left-handed? Oh, actually, let's use the hand with the stone on it.
Okay.
And just tell me real quick, where are you from?
Michigan.
Michigan. What do you think about some of this stuff?
It's pretty incredible.
Yeah? Okay, I don't want this to, this will not hurt, I promise.
Okay.
So I'm gonna take the penny that I struggled on, and do you feel it in your hand?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I'm gonna press down. Does that hurt?
No.
Make a fist. Turn your hand over. Squeeze the penny. And do you feel anything happening?
No.
No, not yet. How about now? No? All right, turn your hand over. Let me just see. Slip flat. Let's try this. I'm just gonna rub here. Just like this. And same kind of thing. You feel that? You see it kind of bending?
I see it. Yeah.
And it's almost as if, and I'm going to use the pressure of your hand, tighten your palm. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Now, grab, I'm going to hold the coin that's bent. With the other hand, grab my two fingers there. Perfect. Squeeze. Perfect. Squeeze again. Go ahead. Did you hear that? Try
Actually, you know what? We're doing more damage. Why don't you keep that for a souvenir?
All right.
And stay up here with me. And would you come up again? Perfect. And stand right here. And would you stand over here? And for you, back up just a little bit. And this, I know everybody loves to see this on film. So we're gonna do the best we can to get it on film. Is everybody in the full picture?
Yeah. I mean, this side, yeah.
Perfect. What I want you to do is relax. I want you to relax. Now, folks, listen. As they're relaxed, I'm going to have them shut their eyes. When their eyes are shut, I'm going to touch one of them. It's very important you see who it is that I touch. Okay? That is so important. And the camera will pick it up. But it's important that you see who it is that I touch. I'm not going to touch anybody. It starts from now on, from here on out. And I won't embarrass you, okay? I'm not going to do anything stupid. Just close your eyes. Relax. Just relax. Just relax. Close your eyes. Relax. Just relax. Close your eyes. Relax. Relax. Close your eyes, just relax. Relax for me. Close your eyes. Keep your eyes closed, raise your hand if you were touched. Open your eyes. Where were you touched? What did it feel like? Say that louder. Thank you very much. You may sit down. Well, they're not going to get what happened, so we're going to explain it. I have a feather.
Yeah.
Now, I did not touch you at all. I didn't get near you with this. I touched her on the nose with this feather.
That's what you felt.
And you felt?
Exactly.
So,
wow.
Thank you very much. Okay, so, want to get into more about this stuff. Does anybody have any questions at this stage?
Sure.
How do you exercise that?
Good question. Do you exercise it? You know what, I don't want this to look like something that it's not. So, I brought with me a deck of cards, okay? Not for tricks, reasons, but to show you how I would like for you to exercise this. And I promise you, as way out there as it might seem, it's not. This is how you exercise your intuition. You get a deck. You shuffle it, okay? You mix it up, you give it a few cuts, whatever, it doesn't matter. And you do this while you're at home, put on some music. Right before you start, I'm gonna tell you what it is you're gonna do, but before you start, you put the deck in front of you like this. Now, you're going to figure out or take a guess. Use your intuition as to what this card is. Okay? It's not something you think about. It's something that comes from you. Intuition. Who here has not experienced intuition? Okay. So here's what you do. You get a deck. You shuffle it. Okay? Then you cut it. You don't want to look at anything. You want to figure out what this top card is. 10 of hearts. 7 of hearts. 6 of clubs. Okay? Give it another cut. Start out with the color, okay? And don't use your, so in other words, you understand that there's different, you know, you've got different spades, clubs, hearts, spades, you know, stuff like that. So let's do color, okay? Black. Now, when you do that, so you give it a cut without, and I'm just doing this so you don't think I'm looking at anything. Now guess what the suits are, the face is. Jack. 8. Queen. So how am I doing that? What am I doing? Let's have you try. Black or red?
Black.
Okay. Most people are going to think that that's a, that could be a lucky guess. It could be 50-50. So let's do this. Don't think of anything yet. At the color of his shirt. Go ahead and do it now. You see the color? Now, what color is it?
Mauve.
Okay.
You talking about medical or?
No.
Yeah.
Put your hands up.
Okay.
Look at his shirt.
Okay.
You see the color?
Yes.
Now look at me. You were looking at his shirt, you saw the color. What's the color? How many water bottles were in front of him?
Two.
In front of, and what else was in front of him that was kind of odd? That stuck out?
His phone?
No. What else? Don't look, but just, this is again guys, this is awareness. Okay. See what's in front of him? The cup. The big cup. Now why didn't you see it? I'm gonna tell you why. Because you are focused on his shirt, as I told you to be. An object, that's how magicians typically got away with things. If I tell him to focus on his shirt, and I kid you not, a pink mouse could run across the table, he would not see it. Now, I'm gonna tell you how to get past that, because I think that's kind of a cool little tool to have, to be observant at all times. So what I want you to do is just pick out a card, any card, it doesn't matter, just so everybody can see.
Oh.
Yep. Perfect. And put your autograph on it real big.
Left front or the back?
Put them, yeah, right there. And would you autograph it as well? Anybody see that?
Yeah,
well,
I saw.
You saw it go to my pocket?
No, but I saw earlier when you were having an autograph something, you put something, or you put your hand in your pocket.
Yeah, I was making sure it was empty because if anybody wants to, they're more than welcome to do that. But I have the card, the signed card, jumped to the pocket. That's how I was asking if you saw that because. And it's your card, right? I mean, I want everybody to see. You only sign one, right? How many cards did you sign?
One card.
Just one. And again, when's
my signature?
You know, you were paying so much attention to the deck, I guess, that...
Right. So let's show you how I do it.
Yeah.
What happens is, you're looking at me, you're looking at the card come to the top.
Mm-hmm.
Before I turn it over, I do this. So slow motion, there's the card. Where is it? In my pocket. You saw it that time. See if you see it again. Now it jumps to my pocket.
That's quick.
So quick.
Yeah.
I look, didn't see that. Look, here's the data. There's the card.
I'm staying.
Now, I don't turn around and do this.
No.
I'm in front of you. Watch it jump to the pocket. Come on. Watch it. From here. Into the pack. There it is.
You appear in your pocket.
Now it's in my pocket.
Smile.
No.
It appears.
Not yet. The whole deck went that time.
Whoa!
The whole entire deck. I only have. Look.
Wow.
If you want to see how that works, watch the video. You'll catch it. Again, I just want to give a little thing about being observant. Now, can I want to talk about something a little bit different. That's totally crazy. That's out of the realm of things. And it's so far out there, it's actually scary. I have an envelope. I have something in it. Let's call it a prediction. I'm gonna set it there, and I'm not gonna touch it. That's my prediction that I'm making right now. I'm committed to it, and I cannot touch it at all. Camera is on me, you guys are on me.
We're watching me.
I'm watching that call. Now, I have a book that I bought. Anybody ever heard of this book? It's called Lord of the Flies.
Yeah.
Okay, I wanted to get it plastic because I wanted to make sure everybody has heard of it before. And who here has read it? Okay, perfect. Do me a favor with this marker. It's not a bleed-through marker, but in a moment, somebody's gonna call out a page number. I just want you to write it as big as you can on your pad. All right, so we've all read this book. Now, let's get into something a little, like I said, this is gonna be very different than anything you had ever seen before. But I'm gonna talk about something before we get into this. You ever been sitting down or doing something and you thought of a name of a person and the phone rings and it's them? What is that? What do you think that is?
Telekinetics.
Actually, it's telepathy. Like, I kind of did telepathy here when I was doing the stuff earlier with the names. Do you know what telekinetics is?
No.
The telekinesis?
Yeah, moving
things
with your mind.
Moving things with your mind.
Thank you.
So, those of you who have not seen it, don't know what it is, have you ever experienced that?
No.
No, have you ever tried?
One time and I was drunk.
Okay. I'm surprised it didn't work. Here's what you have to do. You have to become in with alignment of the object.
Okay.
When you get within alignment of any object, stand up.
Okay.
Hold your hand out like this. Again. I want to put, you feel heat coming off my hand?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to try this while you're holding it. You're going to feel, you feel that? Right
yes.
There? That's energy.
That's, all right, questions.
I was stepping away because I don't think I'm using a string or something, so. And I'm not gonna touch it, so. Actually, let's do this and make this more fair. Will you take this fork out of there?
Sure.
And put it on top so I don't touch it.
Okay.
And just balance it on top. Perfect. And it's plastic, right? I've heard people tell me when I do this, I got a magnet installed in my hand or whatever. I mean, and I want you to move your hand in a circle around it. Okay? Now in your mind, tell it to move.
Four?
Yep.
Put your finger on that card.
Yep. And just say it in your mind that you want it to move.
Okay, I'm telling myself in my mind that I want it to move.
Anything happening?
No.
All right. Watch yourself. Just put your hand down for a second. Shake my hand. Shake my hand. All right, now watch. Do what I do, okay? Just go like this. When you go like this, go like this. And the fork, do you see any movement at all?
It's a little bit. Like
it did move a little bit. All right, sit down for a second. I'm going to spin. And putting your hands to it. When I had this in your hand and moved it, you felt it, right?
Yes, sir.
Name any number, real quick, from 1 to 10.
8.
It's not going to be an 8. I want you to think about what that card is. I mean, I really want somebody to be able to do something. Right now, tell me what that card is.
3.
Huh? 3. 3? Okay, and there's a suits, diamonds, hearts, spades, clubs. Turn it over. She said a red 3. We'll give that to her. The first time you had to think, the second time you didn't think.
That's right.
Is that correct?
That's correct.
That's the point here, is you cannot think. Okay, so. Who has good eyes? Do you have good eyes?
Sure.
I bought. Have you read this book?
Yes. Not in a long time.
Okay, no, that's fine. Just stand there. This guy is like on the ball. Right? He's like ready. He's like, okay, we're going to take the bookmark. This is mainly for the skeptics. I'm going to look away. I'm going to write it down. Just say stop. Okay? Now, how long ago would you say has it been that you read this book?
20 plus years.
Okay. Maybe it might not work.
Eighth grade. Yeah.
All right, here we go. Just say stop.
Stop.
There?
Mm-hmm.
Did I stop where you told me to?
Yeah.
All right, now what I want you to do is take a guess as the page you stopped at.
100.
Okay. Look at the page number. Say it out loud.
78.
Just look at the first word.
You're covering it. Electric.
I didn't want you to say it, but...
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's okay. That's okay. Did you write it down?
The first one?
The first... The page number?
Yeah.
What was it again?
78.
Hold on the book?
Yeah.
Show us.
I wrote
it. She said 78.
She said 78.
Yeah, the first paper book.
All right.
You missed it up.
Yeah, I guess I messed up.
No, write 78. Okay. Go big. All right. All right, set it in front of everybody. Show it. Let me see. Will you pass that up to me? And the first word was electric.
Yeah.
Okay, that's okay. Do me a favor. Cover the book like this. This is the final subject I don't want to talk about. Then I'm going to round out everything. I want something to happen here. And I'm going to will it to happen. I'm going to put the thought out there and we're going to make this happen. Did you feel anything?
Nope.
This is our page. The first word on the page was electric. Will you turn to page 78 again? Is 78 there? Show us. It's ripped out.
Where's it at? Yeah. Where did you put it?
Hold on. That's. See that envelope?
It's in there.
Oh, wow.
That's been sitting there the whole entire time. Oh, hold it up.
No way.
With the charts. Would you do me a favor? Just go like this. I want you to show your hands empty, but I want you to take that envelope. But keep it on the table. I want you to open it up real slow and pull out the contents that's in it. Everything that's in it. Is that everything? Will you make sure that that page matches exactly to this? Because rips can only be, put it in, see if it matches. Look at the first word on the page. Is everything a match?
Electric.
Is it perfect?
Yeah.
Happens. What do you think?
I think some of their bookmarks when you showed it to me.
I got to actually give him that too for a souvenir. In case he would pass this down to him. Thank you for reminding me, but no. So, again, if you want things to happen your way, right? What's the best way you know to do that? If you really want something to go your total 100% complete way,
be positive and look at it, you know, the outcome of it positively.
And visualize.
Yeah, visualize the way you want it to end up.
Brandon, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
You believe in the law of attraction?
Sure.
Any successful person will tell you that they believe in the law of attraction. I don't care who you ask. Bill Gates, all the way down, they all believe in the law of attraction. This is everything I've shown you today. It's where it all stems from. Okay? Again, no tricks. I'm using your coin. I'm using, thoughts out of your mind. Okay? You accomplish this by having a strong sense of knowing who you are. If you can't be, if you don't love yourself and love the person you are, then you can't expect you to make anything happen in your life, relationship-wise or work-wise, right? You have to be happy with yourself before you can be happy with the job that you do at work. Does that make sense? Can everybody agree with that? Okay, so using techniques, using your mind to think. Nobody's ever gonna ask you to bend a coin or rip a penny in half. Okay? No one's gonna ask you that. But I'm doing this because I wanted to show you that it's possible. I mean, it can be done. No tricks here. I mean, if your boss says to you, I need this done and that done, everybody in their mind has a tendency to think that they're constantly, at that moment, put into pressure. And then they try and think of the best way to do it, and within a time restraint. You can't do that, right? You have to do, if you rush with something, you're gonna do it half-ass. If you think it through, right? Not make mistakes, mistakes come because people don't think things through. I went, if you guys get anything out of this today, I really want you to get that. Use your head. I mean, in different aspects, right? You know, focus. Don't try and, you know, don't read something. Focus on it. Get more out of it. You know, if you write down a word and tell me what that word says, and you say it says this, and you just, okay, now, get what comes to mind with that. You know, really think about things. You know, think about things, really go into detail. Detail is everything, okay? You want to have details of what's going on in your mind, because everybody thinks differently. So if you have a project coming up, right? Stress only holds you down. That's where the old saying of wait. Don't stress it, you know, really focus. When you do that, you become so much better of a person, and everything you touch will just turn to gold. Okay? You have to be happy with yourself when you wake up. Because if you're not happy with yourself, you're not gonna make anybody else happy. Be motivated, right? I really want you guys to leave here today feeling some sort of awakening. Raise your hand if you do.
I want to bend the border after we get out of here.
Perfect. I'm not here to trick you. I'm not here to try and, you know, demonstrate something that's not is. I'm here because I want you to gather some kind of inspiration. And, you know, really just keep, you know, change the way you do things. If you keep doing what you're doing, you're going to keep getting what you're getting. Okay? So I'll leave it at that. Thank you very much.